Hi everyone at Truluck. This is Dan from Raw Seafoods. We're located in Fall River, Massachusetts, and today we're going to talk to you about this journey of these great New England deep sea wild-caught sea scallops. So we're about 200 miles offshore on this boat. This is the fishing vessel, the Venture, and they're getting ready to drop a dredge. This one's actually on the port side, and they have another one that's already out there that's on the starboard side. They're going to drop these out and end up being about 200 feet down in the bottom of the ocean. This tow is probably going to last 20 minutes, 25 minutes, depending on what they're going to feel is in there on both of these dredges. Let's take a look at the bottom of the ocean. Again, 200 feet down. The current here is pretty swift. The nutrients in the water are incredible, which makes these the best scallops in the world. They're firm, they're sweet. There's nothing like the New England deep wild-caught sea scallop. So once the dredge is full, and they'll feel this as they're towing the boat, they want to take these up and not overpack the boat because they want to have these shucked and into the shucking area before they have the next one come in. So as you can see, they're dumping on both sides with these two hauls and these turtle-friendly dredges that they brought up. This is a heavy regulated industry. It was actually fished out in the early 1990s, and it's really come back really well. So they're going to unhook these dredges and dump everything right onto the decks. Now the work begins. And as you can see, this is a calm day out at sea. Imagine doing this with 10, 15 foot waves. Right now what they're doing is picking the pile, and they're going to take these orange baskets with the scallops and bring them into the shucking room. There's one on each side, and there's also one up in the bridge because the captain also shucks. Watch the speed of these guys. They have to hand shuck every single one of these scallops. Now, the shells go back in the ocean, the viscera go back in the ocean, and what we're doing is just taking this abductor muscle and putting it into these pails. Once they're put into these pails, we're going to put them into this washer right away. Now, you can see we want to get these off the deck because during the summer it's 100 degrees out there. The condition of these, we want to get them within the hour down below. So this machine is going to take these scallops and bring them up into a washer that you see right here, where we're going to take salt water, rinse off the sand, rinse off the shells, and gently put them into this tube. Now, once they go into this tube, this is pretty cool. They're actually going to send these below deck into the hold, which is packed with ice and it's insulated. So imagine you're going to be walking into a refrigerator down there all year long. Now what they're doing, you can see the tubs where the scallops came down, and the guy in the blue is putting about 50 pounds into that bucket, and he's going to take this bucket and dump it into this bag. The bags average about 50 pounds, 51 pounds. They're random. And they're gently going to put them in here. And this is something cool that we're working with this boat on around the Venture and his other vessels. After these are bagged, he's going to take them. This is the captain here in the great shirt. That's Captain Tim. And he's going to take this bag and he's going to put it on a scale because they have to measure and keep count of everything on there because they're only allowed to take so many scallops up. But this new hardware and software, watch this. He's going to say, okay, it's 51.8. He has everything all set up and all the data that he wants to capture. Is going to hit print. And out of the printer, you're going to see a QR code come out. Now, this is also being uploaded to the cloud in real time as well, so we can track these scallops from the minute in the location they're caught. So if we take a look at this tag, we can see the fish ventral adventure, we see Captain Tim, the bag count, the location, the latitude, the longitude, and the actual time that this bag was actually put together. At this point, we're going to track it. And again, like I said, this is also uploaded to the cloud and we share this information with them. And you're going to see a lot of ice from this point on. Tim is going to take these into the hold. And our goal, the best refrigerant in the world is ice. And you're going to see him just pack these because this is going to be probably a 7-day, 8-day trip. And now we're coming back into the port of New Bedford. And New Bedford, Massachusetts, the whaling capital of the world back in the 1800s, once the richest city in the world, is going to come in, and you can see they're going to unload all of these scallops, and you can see the amount of ice that they want to keep these under. That's going to best refrigerate it we could possibly think of. At this point, they're going to haul them out from down below, and we're right at dockside, and it's going to go onto a loading tray. And at this point, these bags are going to be weighed again. We're going to shave all that ice off the outside of it. We're going to put them on the scale, and the captain will record the actual weights for the second time. Again, into a vat, this plastic box, and we load that up with ice as well. Once it leaves the loading dock, we're going to put it directly onto our truck, And this truck is going to go to Fall River, Massachusetts. It's about a 20-minute ride. And you can see it coming off the truck. And this is Paul Neves. He's in charge of our fresh scallop production. He's going to check every single vat that's going to come in. He's going to check the smell. He's going to check the size. He's going to check the consistency. You know, make sure that they were cut the right way. From there, Paul is going to send some samples into our quality assurance lab. And this technician, what he did is he actually ground some of the scallops. And he's going to be putting them into these testing units, which is actually going to measure the amount of moisture that these scallops have. Like you and I, being a mussel, we have a lot of moisture in it. And as you can see, these scallops were 79.68% moisture, which is what we call a dry scallop. He's going to take that and put it into his report. Also, anything else that he sees, the size, the smell, the texture. Once it gets approved, we take them from our vats now. Again, you can see the ice, and we're going to gently open. And this is where our superpower is. As great as these scallops are, these next steps are critical to what you're going to be receiving at your restaurants. So we're dumping these scallops into a vat here that mimics the ocean. This is a seawater brine. We want to make sure the shells and sand or any viscera is completely off. So it's like the third time that this product has gone through it. These are our associates. And what they're doing right now is taking all the chunks and the pieces that are out of there. We want to make sure we bring you a whole mussel. As great as everything else is, this is where our superpower is. We don't want to have any chunks or pieces going to you whatsoever. They're actually sizing at the same time. Every single scallop, this is probably a 10-20 or a U12 at this point. But they just want to make sure the sizes are right and consistent. So when you're plating, the same size scallops end up on the plate. You don't want one big one and one small one. Now it's going to go into these blue trays. We also put them into those metal cans at time, depending on the customer preference. So we're going to take these and she will put them over to the scale. And what we'll do is make sure that we have a 10-pound unit at this point. And again, checking to make sure there's no chunks or pieces, any sand, any grit whatsoever. After this is done, we're going to be putting this into our scallop holding room. And from the scallop holding room, then it'll take it out and we'll put them at the styro, pack again into ice. Make sure we seal these completely so they're in the best shape and the best condition. They don't get any damage in transit to you whatsoever. Right onto the pallets. And from the pallets, we're going to take these and put them directly onto our refrigerated truck. Even though they're packed in ice, we just want to make sure that we keep these below 38 degrees for the entire journey, getting to your stores, getting to your coolers, and getting to your chefs, so you can have the greatest possible scallop that you're presenting to your customers as well. So hopefully this was informative. If you ever need any additional information, please reach out to us. We enjoy selling you our scallops and hope you enjoy them. Take care now.